In today's video, we're going to have a look at the Palissy Briefcase by Carl Friedrik, as you can see on the box here. Now, before we get started, full disclosure, this video has been made in collaboration with Carl Friedrik. So they have loaned me this briefcase and asked me to show it to you. So this is a collaborative video. Also, as part of the collaboration this time, we've been able to set up a voucher code, and that will allow you to get 15% off anything in the whole Carl Friedrik range, not just this briefcase, any item you like, and that voucher will last for about a month. So if you have a look in the description under the video, I'll put all the details down there of where you need to go if you want to buy something for yourself and get that 15% off. So if you're not familiar with Carl Friedrik as a company, they were founded in 2012, so it's quite a young company, and they are based in London in England, and obviously I'm based in England as well, but in the north of England. And the way the company works is that they design the goods in London, and then the majority of their goods are actually manufactured in Italy. And they're very transparent about that, which is something to be appreciated about the company. There are a lot of companies these days who sort of they'll just put London, England on an item or something, and it's supposed to give you the idea that it's been made in London or made in England, and really it hasn't. It's been made very cheaply abroad somewhere. It's a little bit sneaky. If you look at any of the Carl Friedrik goods on their website, they have a little section at the side which tells you exactly where all the parts are from and exactly where it was made. So there's an honesty and a transparency there with where your goods are actually coming from, and then you know that it's been made in Italy or somewhere, rather than, you know, Bangladesh or somewhere that would obviously be much cheaper. Carl Friedrik also sell their goods directly, so there's no end retailers adding any kind of profit or markup onto the items. And what that means is that you're getting really high quality items, but much more cheaply. Okay, so let's unbox the item. This is still in the sellotape. I haven't unboxed it at all, so you'll get to see what you would see if you were buying this item. So let's carefully unbox this, because obviously it's on loan, and then we'll have a look at the item inside. Okay, so we've got a nice dark inner box there inside the packaging. You can see that they've got the company logo spot varnished black on black onto the box there, which is quite classy. It is quite a classy company. I'm not what you would call a very stylish person, but I can appreciate nice things. So let's have a look inside here. Okay, so here's the item inside the box, and as you can see, it comes in a nice storage bag as well, a cloth storage bag. And what these are designed for is if you were to put something like this away in a wardrobe or something like that, then it just keeps it clean and tidy in the wardrobe. And it's the kind of thing that you often get with high-end ladies' bags and things as well. Okay, so let's bring this out of here. So here's the briefcase in the bag. So let's actually open the bag now and have a look. So we've got a drawstring at the top to keep that closed. Okay, so let's get the briefcase out of the bag. Okay, so here is the item. So this is the Palissy briefcase. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. And they've sent this in the cognac colour with a red lining, which you can just see peeping through there. Now this is available, I think, in 4 different colours and 2 different lining colours, which means you've actually got 8 colourways that you could choose from. And if you have a look on the website, you can see all the pictures of those different combinations there. You have to think with leather about how you want it to age and things like that as well. These kind of lighter colours will often patina a lot more than darker colours. So if you're the kind of person who, it's always a funny thing really. People buy brand new leather goods and then they can't wait for it to look like it's 50 years old these days. You know, people like the patina, the wear and the aged look and so on. And this leather will patina nicely, which we'll go on to in a short while. But as I say, the lighter leather colours like this will tend to patina a little bit more than darker leather colours as well. So before we have a look inside the item, have a look at the features and things, let me explain a little bit about the leather that this is actually made from. So it's a Tuscan vachetta leather, and the vachetta is a full grain vegetable tanned leather. So essentially you're buying a really nice bag made out of quality leather. You know that it's going to look nice, it's going to age nicely, patina nicely, and so on. And it's also, you know, it's going to be strong and durable and everything that you would expect out of a high quality bag.
Let's have a look at the outside. So first of all, we've got the handles. Now these are rounded handles, so they've got a core of something inside, which will be something like a very thick rope or something like that. That gives them a nice rounded appearance. The handles are attached to this strap here. And if we look at that strap, it runs down the bag, it runs underneath the bag, and it runs right up to the other side here. And they've done that for strength in the design. So again, that all comes down to the weight and things. What's happening here is that this strap is cradling the whole piece. It's right, all the strength in this leather is supporting the entire bag. It's not actually pulling on the front of the bag. So that's really nicely made, and it's going to give a lot of strength and longevity to the item. So we've also got on the front a little slip pocket here, which you could pop a phone in or something. I've just stupidly tried to find my phone to put it in to show you, and then remembered that it's filming the video, which would be why I can't find it. So the back is just plain there. Okay, so let's have a look inside. So we've got a zip, and the way the zip's designed is that it's going to open the majority of the bag. It's a three-sided zip, so it comes up and over and down, and that's going to let you get right inside the item. So rather than just opening the top like this and sort of, you know, fishing about and you can't quite see inside, you can do that if you want to quickly get something out, or if you want to, you can open the zip right the way up and then really open this up and see, you know, see what's going on inside if you need to. Okay, so we've also got inside here a shoulder strap. It looks like the strap itself is nylon underneath and then faced with leather. So again, that's to add some strength to the item. So a nylon backer and then a leather top, and that will be the same leather as the bag, I expect. Got an extra little clip on each side, look offset. So there's one here and one here. So if we want to attach the strap, so then we're turning that into a shoulder bag. Okay, so the inside is quite unfussy in terms of how it's divided up. So it's not, you know, they've not tried to add lots of sections or anything. There's just a big main section in there. So on this back side, we've got slip pockets here. We've got a leather plate, and that says on it, Carl Friedrik, designed in London, handmade in Italy, Tuscan Vachetta leather. So also on this back side, there's a zip pocket here. A reasonable depth zip there, so I have a hand's depth, so you could put, again, phone or whatever you want in there. All these zips feel like nice quality as well. I believe these are Italian hardware zips. The last thing you want on a nice bag is a cheap zip. It's just not worth it. Because it's so difficult to replace, you know, if something goes wrong. But these all feel like nice zips. So we turn that around. Look at the other side. We've got two pen loops there to pop a pen in. And then we've got an unzipped section here as well. So an open section there. So, of course, one of the things that people often want to use a briefcase like this for these days is actually as a laptop bag. Because in days gone by, people used to carry huge amounts of papers around, you know, reports and files and things like that. And these days, as things slowly go a bit more paperless, oftentimes people are carrying a laptop or an iPad or, you know, something like that. And of course, laptop bags come in all shapes and sizes. So what people often want is a laptop bag that's a little bit more professional looking. So if you're the kind of person who goes to work in a nice suit, you know, suit and a tie, and you look smartly dressed or something, the last thing you want to do really is have a kind of black nylon laptop bag, you know, that's a little bit cheap looking. So this laptop isn't mine. This actually belongs to my work, but because of the coronavirus, I've been at home, working at home since March. So I happen to have this work laptop here, so I can show you this in the bag. So this is a 15-inch MacBook Pro. And we'll see if this fits in here okay. So I guess your options here are either you put it in the main section of the bag, or if it'll fit, then we can also slide it in this back section here. So let's have a look and see how that actually fits. Okay, so the laptop will go in that slip pocket at the back, but it's a little bit tight. to be honest. It wants to be a little bit bigger for that to go in there. It will only just fit, although this leather binding on the pocket will probably stretch a little bit over time if you did want to put that in there. So it's gone in, but it's a little bit tight. So I would say you would be better off just in the main section of the bag like that. And then there's plenty of room there for other things as well inside. Okay, so my overall impression of this, having had a look at it, is I think it's a really nice bag. I think the design is made to be strong. As we say, with these straps here, they've thought about the longevity of the item, they've thought about the weight somebody might want to put in this. It's comfortable with the nice rounded handles. It's a really nice quality leather. It's a really nice looking colour. Good quality hardware. I like the fact that you get a shoulder strap and it's removable, so you can convert the bag to whatever kind of carry you like. And I think as an accessory, a sort of business accessory, it's very stylish looking. It's the kind of thing that you would get good, nice compliments on as well. And I will say as well that I think on the website they market this as a gentleman's case. I don't see any reason at all why this can't be for ladies as well. There's nothing overly masculine about it. And I think in, this day and age, to make such distinctions really doesn't make that much sense for something like this. So I would say for either gentlemen or ladies, this would be, really a really nice accessory. And as well, as I say, it would make a great gift if you wanted to buy one for somebody.
So remember, if you do want to buy yourself anything from the range, either this Palissy briefcase or anything else, you've got that 15% off voucher code, but it will only last for about a month. So if you're watching this video and you feel like treating yourself, then now is the time to use that if you want to. Okay, hope you've enjoyed that video, and I'll see you next time.